I was trained as a portrait painter. I was a realistic painter. I used to paint landscape, still lifes in very much close to British and Dutch, French art. Then after analyzing the both Eastern paintings and then Western paintings, I formulated my own style. Colors, when it comes to colors, I was earlier using a lot of bright colors. And I tried to adopt the Indian sense, to bring Indian feeling in my painting. I used those colors. I was also exposed to church art, the artwork done by the great masters. Some of the works were like Titian, and then Da Vinci, and then Michelangelo, and then Rubens. And I like the crucifixion, adoration, and all these compositions I always admired. I used to come and draw at home, remembering, having the memory in my me, and then I used to take it to my school and show it to my drawing master. I was born in Bangalore, and in the city itself, school where I studied was St. Joseph's Indian High School in Bangalore. Joined maybe very early in 1945 and studied till 56. And that was the time when I was 4 to 6, I still remember. And that was the early time of my inspiration. And then I was associated with the church, Catholic Church, and then I used to go to Catholic Church almost every day. I was a choir member, I was an altar boy, and then I used to serve the church activities and everything. And I was struck by the stained glass windows of the churches.
Probably one of South India's best artists, Mr. Alphonso Doss, happened to be a very good friend, because though he's very much senior to me, he always treated me as a friend. Despite the Madras College of Art influence, he has achieved a style of his own and a narrative expression which is very original to himself.
Group of my friends used to go and see the trees and plants and flowers, and then I was admiring only the statues of Queen Victoria and King George V, because I realized the beauty of intricate carving done by the British masters. My master, Mr. Selvaraj, used to give me some examples from old engraving prints, asked me to copy. I learned the intricate lines and then intensity of form and gradations and figure compositions. And 57 I left the school and came to Madras because there was no art school at the time in Bangalore, and there was one in Mysore. My father did not want me to go there, but he asked me to go to Chennai because the Chennai school was very popular during Roy Choudhury time, and the school was actually formulated by Britishers, one Alexander, and then Robert Chisholm, and then Hardaway, and there so many people were there, and was very well known, one of the best institutions even today. Fortunately, I had very good teachers like Roy Choudhury, Panikkar, Anthony Das, Santana Raj, Munnuswamy, Ramagopal was my first art teacher, and then Dhanapal and Krishna Rao, they're all excellent masters. After finishing my course there, I was offered a job at the Madras Art School, and I stayed 3 years in 2.5 years in Kumbakonam School of Arts. I was transferred to Madras School again. That was the finest period of my time, where I was experimenting, discussing with students, and then reacting with their work and my paintings, and then analyzing everything, and then there was a beautiful library which gave a lot of information about Western master artwork and the art and architecture. I was totally involved and then dedicated to the work. When I was a student, most of my time was spent in isolation, and I like isolation, abandoning the society to villages to isolate myself.
From my childhood, I'm very emotionally attached to him as one of my favorite uncles. All of us cousins, we waited. He was a very generous person. He could come down to our wavelength and gel well. He used to take us to Brigade Road. We used to go shopping. And the best thing is he used to take us and buy burgers those days when it just came to Bangalore. Burgers was like something very fascinating to all of us.
I was fascinated how the light passes through the stained glass windows and create a kind of feeling. All the images of Christ, Madonna and other saints, and very colorfully painted, which was prepared in Paris or Germany. The whole atmosphere is illuminated. The most important period in my life was when I went to United States Smithsonian Institution, where I visited the Mines and Geology section, where I found the very valuable gemstones and diamonds were preserved and then properly lit. And then I was struck by that stones, and then I started studying the light passing through the diamond or gemstone, how it projects light, and it transforms totally and bring out a new kind of effect in the crystal glasses. And then this I was able to connect immediately to my early experience with stained glass windows, where the light passed through the color glasses. The Indian painters like Mughal miniatures, Persian miniatures, and then the Hindu temple art, Ajanta kind of paintings, they applied one color for the figure and the other one was the line. The line and this single dimension. And then the light is distributed all over. So after visiting the temple architecture and the temple paintings and the collections in the museum, I thought, why not I use those elements or forms, because I was using European techniques. So I wanted to combine these Western techniques and the Indian form, and then I want to bring a unique style of my own, and that was very, very difficult. With the linear quality of the temple art. And my teacher Santanaraj used to tell me, the line is very important in art. Cavemen painting in the caves, and then the line was the most important element in art. And it continued. And the line had a lyrical quality, and then flowing spirit. And then the artist able to express what he wanted in a simple language. So I have learned a lot of things by visiting Ajanta, Ellora, various architectural important cities like Khajuraho, Konarak, and then Puri, Jagannath, and Banaras, and then from even Indian art from Mauryan, Shunga, and then Gupta, and so many Chola, Pallava, every art movement, Badami, Pattadakal, Mysore, and then I see very different kind of sets of people. And then I use those forms, and the beautiful hairstyling, and then the costumes, and then jewelry, all this in Indian miniature paintings, which gave me a lot of inspiration to do small paintings. After seeing the Ajanta Ellora, I thought, why not I paint a large mural on canvas.
When I think of Alphonso, sir, the first thing that comes to my mind is about a gentle, a soft human being. He would be in class and he would be painting in the background. Most of his themes would be fascinating in the sense it would be something to do with a religious background or cosmic energy and some kind of a philosophical aspect to that.
In Chennai, Madras, most of my students are working with the cinema. I mean, they work as costume designers, set designers. One Krishnamurti was there, he was my classmate. Sabu Cyril, and then Tota Tharani, and JK. Very successful, they lot of earn money and everything. Very few, they are confident to live as an independent artist. After visiting the museums in Europe and then America, I found the Chinese paintings have a glow in their artwork, and they use just brush strokes and color, leaving the paper white or canvas white. So I try to adopt that technique in my present work. It is European masters who have used heavy impasto technique, using white and blending with other colors, but the Chinese Eastern masters, Japanese and Chinese masters, have used very light, thin, transparent color, and they were able to bring out very beautiful effect in the painting. Contemporary art started in the beginning with the support of the European travelers. Foreigners used to visit India. They wanted to pick up souvenir-like art which represents India. That is how the Indian artists were motivated to paint. And then some of them, like Jamini Roy and others, started painting the folk style of art, but when it comes to contemporary art, starting from early times like Hussein, Hebbar, and then Ara, and then Akbar Padamse, and then others, they established their names, and it was genuine in those times. Art dealers were they have not come into the picture because the artists themselves started promoting their art, and then selling their artwork, and then stayed together with an association. The most beautiful creation in nature is woman. And then I was very much influenced or inspired by women, not only their physical appearance, but also the psychological support one can give for artists, the musicians and the painters and anybody. And subconsciously I thought they are very strong force behind any individual. I regarded them so much, I was afraid also. During my travel, I used to appreciate women and their features, physiological and physiognomical expressions of their selves. The worst part of my self is my imagination. I think my imagination is my enemy. So that may be one of the reasons why I wanted to stay single. I lived all through my life single, but the woman has been the backbone of my painting, all my paintings.